Ibrahim ibn Adham, a great, a virtuous man from the time of the Tabi'in. Ibrahim ibn Adham, once he was in Iraq, especially the city of Basra. And the people of that city, when they saw this great man, they said to him, O Ibrahim ibn Adham, Ya Aba Ishaq, Inna Allah Ta'ala yaqul, Wa qala rabbukum ud'uni astajib lakum. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala has said in the Quran, Ud'uni astajib lakum. Make dua to me and I'll accept it. Send your dua and I will answer them. But we make dua all the time and none of our dua is being accepted. What is going on? And subhanallah, let us listen to the answer that Ibrahim ibn Adham has given. Not a year ago, not 10 years ago, not a century ago, not 500 years ago, no, over 1,000 years ago. But over 1,300 years ago, look at the answer that Ibrahim ibn Adham has given. And let us see ourselves today, how we agree with him or disagree with him. Everyone, get ready to listen and to hear what Ibrahim ibn Adham has said with regards to why our dua is not being accepted. Subhanallah, Ibrahim ibn Adham has said, لِأَنَّ قُلُوبَكُمْ مَاتَتْ بِعَشْرَةِ أَشْيَاءَ. He said, the reason Allah doesn't answer your dua, let me tell you, is for 10 reasons. Because your hearts have gone dead for 10 reasons. And he's going to tell us one after the other. And he said, number one, عَرَفْتُمُ اللَّهِ وَلَمْ تَأَدُّوا حَقَّ. He said, you have come to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know who Allah is, but you do not fulfill his rights. Isn't that true? We know Allah, but we don't do what he tells us to do. Number two, he said, وَقَرَأْتُمُ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَمْ تَعْمَلُوا بِهِ. He said, you recite the Quran day and night, but none of you practices the Quran. That's number two. And number three, he said, وَزَعَمْتُمْ حُبَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ وَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّتَهُ. You claim to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but you never follow his sunnah. How true is it? وَزَعَمْتُمْ حُبَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ وَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّتَهُ. And he said number four, وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ وَوَافَقْتُمُهُ. You said that shaitan is our enemy, but you always agree with him. How is that possible? He said, always you say, shaitan is our enemy, we hate Iblis, but you always agree with him. You follow his ways. And let me tell you number five, he said. Number five, وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّكُمْ مُشْتَاقُونَ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمْ تَعْمَلُوا لَهَا. You always say that we love Jannah. We crave for Jannah. We all want to go to Jannah. But you don't really act as if you want to go to Jannah. Isn't that true? And the next one. He said, وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّكُمْ تَخَافُونَ النَّارِ وَلَمْ تَهْرُبُوا مِنْهَا. You always say that you are fearful of hellfire. Or we're scared of hell. But you never run away from hellfire. Rather, you're running towards hellfire. Isn't that what we do day and night? And look what else he said. Subhanallah. وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ حَقِّ. You say, he said, you say that death is inevitable. It will definitely come. But you are not ready to die. You don't prepare yourself for death. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us a time is going to come when death will happen very frequently. And people will die just like that, without any illnesses, without any accidents. Just, you will just die. Subhanallah. Isn't it something that is happening now that we see all the time? Ibrahim ibn Adham, he also said, وَاشْتَغَلْتُمْ بِعُيُوبِ النَّاسِ. Please listen to this. وَاشْتَغَلْتُمْ بِعُيُوبِ النَّاسِ وَتَرَكْتُمْ عُيُوبَكُمْ. This is another reason, he said, why Allah doesn't accept your dua. He said, you have busied yourself. You have preoccupied yourself with the shortcomings of other people and you have forgotten your own problems. How true is it? You tell me. We are always busy with the faults of other people,
We always criticize others.
Don't speak to this person. Don't go to this place. This person is evil. That person is evil. How good are you? Are you an angel? It's a question that we need to ask ourselves.
He said, you have become busy with the faults of other people and you have forgotten your own faults. And then also he said,
وَأَكَلْتُمْ نِعَمَ اللَّهِ وَلَمْ تُؤَدُّوا شُكْرَهَا. He said, you are eating from the blessings of Allah. That's exactly. Look how big I am. Day and night, I'm eating from the blessings of Allah. But am I grateful to Allah? That's another thing.
You are not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't show your gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not grateful. And we are not. And I'm number one. And he said,
وَدَفَنْتُمْ مَوْتَاكُمْ. And that's, this is something that we're going to do right now. And we've been doing it for a long, long time.
وَدَفَنْتُمْ مَوْتَاكُمْ وَلَمْ تَعْتَبِرُوا بِهِمْ فَكَيْفَ يُسْتَجَابُ لَكُمْ.
Subhanallah. Very intellectual. Look at the intelligence. He said, you take and you go to the graveyard, to the cemetery, to bury your people. But you don't take any lessons from that. You don't take any heed from it.
Look at, he spoke to us, subhanAllah, in a way that we can all understand.
Is there anyone that doesn't understand those reasons? How many did you give a tick? I gave all the 10 a tick. I'm suffering from all of them. I don't know how many you are suffering from. This is who we are. SubhanAllah.